Next tonight, we look back to the Edinburgh of 1914, when the city was in the grip of patriotic war fever. We'll look at Macrae's Battalion of Royal Scots, also known as the Sporting Battalion, made up largely of professional and amateur sportsmen. But it was players from Hearts, leaders of the Scottish League and considered one of the best teams in Britain, that led the charge.
Sent as many players as Hearts did to the war. Queen's Park sent quite a few, but I don't think any club sent as many as 30. Of the 30 who went, 6 were killed in action, 1 died in service, 13 were gassed or wounded, or indeed both, and only 10 come home unscathed. Discussion of players before they decided to volunteer. There was all sorts of complications with regards to their contract with Hearts, would they serve together, where would they be, they wanted to be as one. They decided in the finish up that their contract was with their country, not with their club. And because of that, because of their actions, they actually sacrificed the league. And the league was lost that season. Celtic won the league at the end of 1914-15 season. You know, they'd only lost one game, but you know, Celtic were crown league champions, but my own humble opinion is that Hearts had won something far more valuable, far more precious than the league championship. By their actions, Hearts had won the respect and the admiration of the whole country. Occasionally, I'm led to believe that McCartney, the manager, would walk into the dressing room and he'd find Jimmy standing there alone, just looking round the dressing room, wondering where his boys were. And although there was other players at Tynecastle, but by that time they weren't Jimmy Duckworth's boys. And Jimmy, he was unmarried, he was a bachelor, he had no family of his own. And he looked in the Hearts players, the ones that were killed, the ones that went to France, they were his boys.
Everyone at the club's extremely proud of that team and the fans who all joined up and I think it underpins a lot of the ethos of the club.
The youngest who went and died was Jim Boyd. His brother Archie was also in Hearts books here as the goalkeeper. They both decided they wanted to volunteer. They went home, discussed it with their mother, who was having none of it. She was prepared to let one son go, but certainly wasn't prepared to let two go. She left the brothers to discuss it amongst themselves. Young Jim decided that he would go as his brother Archie was engaged to be married. Archie had more to lose. That was Jim's thoughts. Jim was killed. Archie never forgave himself for it, and he lived with it for the rest of his days. He blamed his death, the death of his brother, on himself, which was quite tragic.
Well, we have to take a short break now.